Hey guys, Jengar here. Welcome to USSR Rank 3 Overview and Guide. Today I'm going to take you through Rank 3 Soviets, which is a very interesting line, very versatile, a lot of nice fighters in there, some good attackers, and a few bombers that have their ups and downs. But I will try to take you through this Rank 3, give you an overview, and hopefully help you to make decisions as you go through the tree. Premiums are gonna come in a later stage, 5 years maybe. I hope this will be a useful video for you that you will have fun watching, and let's enjoy the ride. Let's go. So we're starting off with the Yak 9K, sitting at 4.0 battle rating in rank 3 right here, first one in the Yak line. And it's a very sturdy looking plane with a huge gun, of course. Armor protection is quite nice. Nice plate for the pilot here. Good bulletproof glass, both in front and behind. 64 millimeters is absolutely fantastic. We have the gun situated right here. Is the Berezin, and then this big monstrosity of a gun. 45 millimeter NS-45 cannon, 29 rounds. At that beast, we've got the fuel nicely and compact, looks pretty nice. We have no bomb options on this plane, so it's a pure fighter with that huge gun. Let's have a look. So here we go with the Yak 9K. Now if you get these caliber guns to hit, they cause massive explosions, and of course that is the fun in the Yak 9K, the first plane in rank 3 in the Yak line, of course, after the Yak 9s, sitting at 4.0 compared to the 3.0 of the Yak 9s. This plane has the same engine and is a full battle rating up. It does have the 45 millimeter cannon, but that doesn't particularly make it easier or anything or better. The 45 is a very acquired taste, and although it is a nice gun, and might be one of the strengths if you like big calibers, I wouldn't personally put it in the strong points. So what exactly are the strong points in this plane? Some people like the 45 millimeter, but if you're not a 45 millimeter specialist, it might actually be harder to hit with this plane. So I wouldn't call it a strength. What is a strength though is the performance below 4000 meters. That's where it's best when it comes to the acceleration and how the plane acts below 4000 meter. This engine is on its best footing. That's where you want to fly it most of the time. There is of course the durability in the Yaks, which is always good. I find these planes to be sturdy and quite nice, reliable, good survivability in this plane. So there is that. Weaknesses in this plane to start off with, of all the Yaks, it's the same. The dive speed, wing rips you will get quite early. And the plane does accelerate quite well, so it's a very dangerous plane in a dive. This is a truth for pretty much all Yaks. So, and this one is no different when it comes to that. So yeah, keep an eye out on the wing rips, and the dive speed is limited. You also have early flap rips in this plane. At 340, the flaps rip off, so it's very risky to use the flaps. They will easily rip off. There is also some overheating in this plane that can be problematic, especially with heavy web usage in a dogfight. Those are the downsides of this plane. The flight style in the Yak is the energy fighting role. That's the main role the plane has. Below 4000 meters, energy fighting in this plane can be a lot of fun. This plane can also close air support, but not because of any ordnance. The plane does not hold any rockets or bombs or anything. But it does have the 45 millimeter heavy hitting cannon that can destroy tanks when you hit them, especially from above or behind. So that you can ground pound when it comes to that with the gun, but it's not something I personally do, but I've heard some people doing that ground RB, and apparently the plane can do pretty well there. Is this plane competitive? I would say yes, definitely. You just have to get used to the 45 millimeter gun, because it is a difficult puppy to shoot with, as the shots are a little bit all over the place. Although I heard they made it a little better. One factor in the plane is medium, and I would also say I recommend it in a medium, not highly, but not low either. It's medium. It's an acquired taste, this plane. You really have to like the big cannon. But if you do like that, then this plane might be for you. Moving on to the Yak 9T, the little brother, although I would say in performance, because of that lighter gun, it might be the bigger brother, but the gun is smaller, so 37mm gun on this one. It sits right here in the tech tree, second one after the K. Very nice. We've got the same armor protection with the same fantastic bulletproof glass right here, giving the pilot some nice protection there. We've got the gun setup that is similar as well. A little bit less big of a monstrosity, but still a huge gun there. Fuel setup is the same. Of course with self-sealing fuel tanks, but that doesn't always save you. Also no armament on this plane, just the gun and the plane. That is what it is, a fighter. Let's check her out. So we're looking at the Yak 9T, sitting at 4.0 battle rating as well, just as the Yak 9K, which comes before it in the line. This one is equipped with a 37mm cannon, which is, for me, a whole lot better than the 45mm cannon. I prefer this one when it comes to that. It also has the same engine as the Yak 9 at 3.0. That's a full battle rating higher, so performance-wise, it stays a little bit limited when it comes to that. It is always a big jump, a full battle rating higher, with the same engine and the same frame, and a little bit heavier as well because of the 37mm cannon. But all in all, the Yak 9T is a very interesting plane, and I much prefer it above the K, but that's just preference. What are the strong points in this plane? The performance below 4000 meters again for the Yaks is perfect. It really acts nicely there as an energy fighter, and with these guns you can finish people off quite quickly. The spread is a little bit more acceptable on these shots that you get from the 37mm compared to the 45, so it's a little bit more reliable as well. A little bit less RNG involved there with the big guns. For the rest, the durability is good. You have armored plates behind the pilot and bulletproof glass in front and behind as well. So this pilot is pretty well protected, so that's nice to have as well. So good survivability, durability in this plane. What are the weaknesses in the Yak 9T? Again, you come to the main weaknesses of the Yaks. The dive speed with the wing rips is very dangerous to be in a long dive with Yaks, and thus you want to avoid this in these planes. And that's also true for the Yak 9T. You have flap rips, which are quite early at 330, 340-ish, same as the Yak 9K. And again, there is the same thing with the overheating. Flight style in the Yak 9T is again energy fighting, which it is a little bit better as than the Yak 9K. I think it has to do with the weight, of course, especially in the vertical. 37mm is just a little bit lighter than the 45mm, which is always good. It can also close air support with the gun, but again, that's mainly the gun. The plane does not have any ordnance, no bombs, no rockets, so no versatility in that sense. But it does have the 37 that with AP rounds you can shoot quite a few vehicles if you want to. But why would you want to? Is the plane competitive? Yes, absolutely. Fun factor for me is medium, because I mean it is an enjoyable plane to fly when it comes to the flight style, but the gun and the RNG involved there is still RNG involved, even if it is less. And with the 45mm, with big caliber guns, you get a lot of spread. There's a big spread with the shot. So if you are aiming correctly, the spread of the gun can pull the shot off target while you were shooting more or less correctly. So that is the downside of these big guns. There is more RNG involved. You have to be a little bit lucky there. So that's why the fun factor is medium. So how high do you value her? Do you recommend this plane? I would say medium. This plane can be very nice. If you like the bigger calibers, you would definitely be good to visit this plane and see how you like the 37. The plane can do very well for you, that's for sure. Here she is, the Yak 3, sitting at 4.0 beta rating as well. It has a little folder together with the Yak 9, 3P, sorry. The Yak 3 4.0, very nice plane. Armor protection is a little bit less extensive, just in the back here. No forward-facing bulletproof glass, unfortunately, so a little bit more risky in head-ons. It has the gun setup, the two 12.7mm Barrison machine guns, and then here in the middle is the 20mm Schwach cannon with 120 rounds. The fuel setup is similar, but the fuel tanks in the wings are a bit bigger. Again, also on this Yak, no ground pounding options, no bombs, no rockets, just this fighter as she is. But what a beauty she is. Lighter frame, let's check her out. Ah, the Yak 3, the sweet spot of the Yaks in rank 3, fantastic. I love this plane, 4.0 beta rating, better engines than the other two Yaks that came before this one. And it shows, man, it shows. It has a lighter frame and it has more horsepower in the engine, which is awesome, giving it more power, more oomph, better acceleration, better performance, better climb rate, all that jazz. Fantastic. What are the strengths in the Yak 3? Well, the offensive guns. I like this setup. That's my personal preference. It has two Barrison machine guns and it has a Schwach 20mm cannon. That is very nice setup for the guns, and I prefer that to the bigger caliber guns. Maneuverability is a strength in this plane. It is a lighter frame. The Yak 3s have lighter frames, and they work very nicely. This plane is much more maneuverable and can function also in the turn fighting role, which is good. You have the performance below 4000 meters especially, but the overall performance is much better, so that is definitely a strength. It has the same battle rating, so there goes that. The durability is still good, still feels solid, so you have durability on your side as well. And the speeds in a straight line are much better than the earlier Yaks, Yak K and the T. So that's a strength here as well. And then there is the climb rate, which is also quite improved with the lighter frame and a stronger engine. It feels much, much better. And for that, at 4.0, this Yak really has my preference. Are there any weaknesses to this plane? Yeah, sure. I mean, still, it's still a Yak, so you have the dive speed to worry about, the early rip, the wing rips, and the flap rips, also at 330, 340-ish. Oh, no, wait a minute. At the Yak 3 has it at 380, so that's slightly better, but it's still early compared to many of the planes you'll be fighting against. But the early flap rippage is still true in the Yak 3 as well. It just lies 40 kilometers an hour higher than in the earlier Yaks. The flight style in this plane is a little bit more versatile, with the possibility of energy fighting and turn fighting. As a turn fighter, you can definitely surprise a lot of people more than you think. Even some dedicated fighters at below 4000 meter altitudes will have problems with a Yak 3, especially if you combine that dogfight with some energy fighting. Is this plane competitive? Yes, absolutely, with an exclamation mark. This is a highly competitive plane at 4.0, and as I said, potentially one of my favorite Yaks out there, but absolutely my favorite Yak in rank 3. But you have to visit this plane. What's the fun factor in this plane? It is high. You can transition from energy fighting to turn fighting, giving you a lot of options. I like this plane. It's very versatile. It feels very, very strong. So there's a high fun factor to this plane. How high do you value this plane? Do you recommend it? Yes, I recommend this plane highly. It is an awesome plane. It is the best Yak at rank 3. And it is fun, fun, fun. So get in this plane and play it, and you will see what I'm talking about. No disappointments. And then we meet the Yak 3P, the Red Danger. Fantastic looking plane. I like the skin. Don't know why it's red, but it works for me. It sits in the tree in the same folder, just here right now, behind the Yak 3, with a 5.0 beta rating, which is quite a step upwards. Not fantastic with the same flight model in the same engine and stuff like that. But anyway, protection from the rear is good. No forward facing protection, unfortunately. We've got the same. We have the same setup with the guns. Only these two are not 12.7 Barrisons, but 20mm B20S cannons. And you have a B20M cannon right here. And that's the setup, with the same setup with the fuel. Again, no bombs on this one, so all similar. But she's still an interesting plane. Let's check her out. We arrive at the Yak-3P, also quite a nice plane, but not my favorite. And I will explain to you why. Same engine and a full battle rating higher. You do get 3 cannons in this plane, but that really does not make a difference when you have Barrisons on the other one. So the Yak-3P, what are the strengths in this plane? Well, you have the offensive guns. They are nice. You get 3 20mm cannons, which can be very nice firepower. I just don't rate them above the Barrisons with 1 20mm on the Yak-3. So, but still, it is a strength in the plane. The maneuverability in this plane is also quite good. It has the same engine as the Yak-3. Same lighter frame, and it does very well in maneuver fights and dogfighting. So yeah, maneuverability is a strength. Performance below 4000 meters is also a strength, and you have good durability. The plane is sturdy, it is very survivable, and I quite like that. So you have those strengths and they are good. Are there any weaknesses to the plane? Well, again, we come to the main thing that most Yaks have, that is the dive speed. It rips early, you get the wing rips, and that is a problem. It's very early compared to some of the other planes that you face. You also have flap rips at 380, same as in the Yak-3. Flight style in this plane, it is an energy fighter, and that should be its main role. It is very good at that, especially below 4000 meters. An absolute beast. But it is less good compared to its competition than the Yak-3, because the Yak-3 sits a full battle rating lower. And it doesn't have any significant downsides compared to this plane. So you have the same plane, only with 320mm at a full battle rating higher, 5.0. And that's a very difficult battle rating, because you'll face all the 6.0s and stuff like that. It is rough for the Yak-3P when it comes to competition. It's still good though, and it can function in those two roles, energy fighter and turn fighting. Turn fighting, it can do very well below 4000 meters, as I said, against the most of the opposition, which is a lot of boom and zooming. A lot of energy fighters. You can definitely turn fight with most planes that you face. Is this plane competitive? Yes, without a doubt, it is still competitive. It just doesn't have the competitive edge that the Yak-3 has at 4.0. This one sits at 5.0, as I said. The fun factor in this plane is medium. Because of the stiff opposition and the full battle rating increase with the same engine and the same frame, the only thing really being different is that you get 320mm. That is not so much of an upside, that it makes the fun factor higher. So it makes it actually lower. You'll get more rougher opposition in this plane. So medium. And do I recommend this plane? How high do I value it? Well, I definitely value it below the Yak-3 a lot, as there is no advantage to fly this plane at 5.0 compared to the Yak-3 at 4.0. But still, it is a fun plane to fly. It is a good plane. You can have a lot of maneuvering fun. But again, here you see my wings going all over the place again. It rips early. It is a plane that is difficult at 5.0 to fly, because the competition is just so much more stiff than compared to the Yak-3. So I would still say that you can fly this plane and try her out, but I would stick with the Yak-3. But still, this not bad. Not bad. Moving on to the MiG line, and the only plane in the MiG line in rank 3 is the I-185 M82, sitting right here, 3.7 battle rating, one of the lower battle ratings on the fighter side here. Fantastic little plane. Armor protection. We have a plate. We have no forward facing protection in a bulletproof glass or anything, but he does have the plate from the back. That is nice. We have the gun placement, 3 20mm cannons, all with different rounds. And here in front we have the big radial engine, which has quite a bit of power, which is nice. We do have some loadouts, some bombs if you want, some rockets. But I would not go ground pounding in this thing, because this is the only Soviet plane that has some performance on the higher altitudes in rank 3. And is a little bit better in dive. So you don't want this plane to go ground pounding. Well, you can, but you can. That's a choice. Let's check her out. So here we have it, the I-185M82, the only plane in the MiG line in this rank, 3.7 battle rating, and quite the interesting plane, I have to say. It is one of the only planes in this rank that is quite nice at the higher altitudes and has nice dive performance. And it is a little bit of a different taste compared to the Yaks and the Lavushkins. But let's go into this plane. The strings in the plane, you have the offensive guns, you get 320 mm, which is a definite upside to this plane. Yeah, good firepower, that's nice. You get better high altitude performance, which is a good strength to have in a plane, and quite unique for the Soviet rank 3. You don't get a lot of planes with good high altitude performance. You also have nice dive performance in this plane, with a much bigger windows in the dive to do you good, so you can actually perform a boom and zoom roll if you want to. The climb rate is also very good, which is good to have because you need to get the altitude on this plane and use it to its strengths. And the plane has very good roll rate, and which is a good thing to have. It almost feels like a Focke Wulf 190, one of the heavier ones, but still, roll rate is nice in this plane. Are there any weaknesses to the I-185? Well, yeah, definitely. Speed is not one of those things. Cruising speeds, maximum speeds in a straight line are not fantastic. It is not the fastest plane in the world. So there is that. And maneuverability, and then especially the turn time, is not great. As I said, the roll rate, it feels a little bit like Focke Wulf 190 for the Soviets when it comes to that. Good roll rate, but turn time is lacking. The flight style in this plane, you can perform two rolls well, and that is the boom and zoom roll and the energy fighting roll. I would say mainly it's still an energy fighter, but in this plane you can definitely do boom and zooming, as the window to ripping and stuff like that is on a different level when it comes to the Yaks, for example. The Yaks are so weak when it comes to that, but this plane is much, much better. Is this plane competitive? Yes, absolutely. And as it is unique to the Soviet line in the high altitude performance and in the dive performance in rank 3, if you like boom and zooming, I would definitely recommend you to visit this plane. What is the fun factor in the I-185? It's high for me. I like the boom and zoom roll. I like the energy fighting, and I like a plane that can combine these two roles. This plane does that, and it does it well. So yeah, there's a high fun factor to this plane. Do you recommend this plane? How high do you value her? Yes, I recommend this plane, absolutely. I highly value this plane. I like it, 3.7 battle rating, good battle rating, good performance, nice in a dive, nice roll rate. It is a competitive plane with good firepower, and unique in the Soviet line at this point for the high altitude performance and the performance in a dive. So yeah, it offers something unique, and I would definitely visit her if I was you. Absolutely fun, the I-185. Hello, Lavushkin line, the LA-5F. Beautiful plane. Here we have her, the LA-5F, sitting at 3.3 battle rating in the line. Ah, the Lavushkins. I like the Lavushkins. A little bit of a sturdier airframe still. A little bit of heavier, but a very good looking plane. We have armor protection, which is very nice. Awesome, especially this plate, 75 mm, but 10 mm here, very nice. And we have the two 20 mm Focke cannons right there. And a big engine with quite a bit of power in there. Fuel setup is quite nice. Small tanks, looks good for the small range distances. We do have two 50 kilogram bombs on there, but the bomb loads are nothing really to speak of, and I wouldn't take it if I was you. But fantastic plane. Let's have a Look at her. Ah, the Lavushkins. We have arrived at the LA-5F, the Lavushkin line. This is the first one in rank 3, coming after the LA-5 in rank 2. 3.3 battle rating this plane. Same engine as the LA-5, but a little bit better performance because of some improvements on the frame, the flight model, which is good. What are the strengths in the LA-5F? Durability is a definite one. You get a little bit of a sturdier plane, a little bit heavier. You get a radial engine, which is much more survivable than the inline engines. You get armored glass, bulletproof glass in front and behind. You get a plate behind the pilot. So this plane has some sturdiness to it, and that is very nice to have. There is, of course, the performance as well. Performance below 3,840 meters. This is where the web stops working. And the plane definitely has great performance below that as an energy fighter. Fantastic in the vertical. Love it. Are there any weaknesses to this plane? Well, yes, of course, there's also weaknesses. The ammo loads are not fantastic. With the 170 rounds per gun, you only have two guns. It's a tight beam. There is that as well. You got to get your aiming on point with most of the Soviet planes. So they have small beams where the bullets will hit. That can be nice if you're good at aiming, but it can also be problematic if you start in these planes. But the ammo loads are a little bit low. High altitude performance is also a weakness in this plane. Doesn't perform well at the higher altitudes, and definitely you still want to climb, but you want to use that altitude to dive on people that are lower than you and get to this plane's perfect altitude, which is between 2,000 and 4,000 meters. The dive compression is also a problem. At the high end of the dive, after 650 kilometers an hour, this plane will compress heavily, and that is a definite downside. Gotta be careful of that. What is the flight style in the LA-5F? It is an energy fighter first, a low altitude energy fighter, and it can boom and zoom a little bit when you need it. But you do not want to make long swooping dives with high speeds because it compresses. You want to make short dives that are easy to get out of and which avoid the weakness of this plane. One of the weaknesses, which is the dive performance. Is it competitive? I would say yes, definitely. This plane can hold its own, especially below 4,000 meters where it really becomes a menace. The fun factor in the plane, I would say, is medium, because it does have the same engine as the LA-5, and it is, well, it's all right, but the LA-5FN, for example, has a definite edge with a better engine. But the fun factor in the LA-5F, I would say medium. Do you recommend this plane? How high do you value her? I could definitely say that it is nice to visit her on your way to the LA-5FN, but I would not stick to the LA-5F. It does not have any particularly upsides compared to the LA-5FN, and thus it is a plane you can visit. It is nice to get into the groove of the Lavushkins in this rank, and then move on to the LA-5FN. We are looking now at the bigger sister of the F, the LA-5FN. This might be one of my favorite planes in rank 3 Soviets. Sits right here, 3.7 battle rating, fantastic battle rating for this plane as well. Looking good. We have the same armor protection on this plane, of course, very nice. We have the dual 20 millimeters here with the same ammo load and the better engine here, which gives this plane quite a bit of a boost in the performance. We also have the 50 kilogram bombs that you could potentially take on this one, but again, I would not recommend you to take these bombs. Just go at it as a fighter. And here we go with the LA-5F. And this is a beast. This one gets an engine upgrade. You get more than 150 horsepower extra compared to the LA-5F. And that is only visible in the slightly higher battle rating at 3.7 battle rating. With 150 extra horsepower, which really makes this plane shine. What are the strengths in the LA-5FN? Durability is exactly the same as in the LA-5F. It has the bulletproof glass, it has the armored plate, it has the radial engine, which is much more survivable than an inline engine. It is just a sturdy, little bugger this plane. Fantastic. The performance below 3840 meters is stunning in this plane with that extra horsepower. Much better in the vertical, even better as an energy fighter. This plane is awesome. This plane also gets fantastic climb rate with that extra strong engine. The climb rate is much improved in this plane, and that makes it so much better. It is it's a stunning difference. I really like this plane. Climb rate is an absolute new strength to this Lavochkin. What are the weaknesses in this plane? Well, the ammo loads are the same as in the LA-5F. You could say that's a little bit on the low side, so I put it in the downsides. But it's better than some of the other 20mm ammos for the Soviets, which is nice. High altitude performance is a weakness. It's not good there, so you just get there so you don't get outclimbed too much. But you want to get to below 4,000 meters as quickly as you can, safely. Don't leave too many planes above you, if you can. The dive speed in the plane is still a problem with the compression. That is just in the airframe, and that's no difference in this plane compared to the LA-5F. So you have that as a downside as well. The flight style in the LA-5FN is energy fighting, of course, and boom and zooming, but the energy fighting component is just quite heavily improved compared to the LA-5F because of that fantastic engine, 150 horsepower, more than that extra, at more or less the same battle rating. It is absolutely stunning as a energy fighter. And as a boom and zoomer, it can perform, but you need to keep that compression in a dive in mind. Is this plane competitive? Yes, with an exclamation mark. Fantastic. One of the highlights of rank 3 Soviets when it comes to fighters. Absolutely fantastic. What is the fun factor in this plane? I would say high. The engine performance is so much better. And it puts this plane exactly in the niche where you want to have it, as an excellent energy fighter below 4,000 meters. You have definitive advantages over other planes at this battle rating in the energy fighting role, which is very nice. So a high fun factor. Do you recommend her? How high do you value her? Highly, yes. I definitely do recommend this plane. It is one of the best planes at rank 3 Soviets, together with the Yak-3. When it comes to fighters, I would definitely say that this is a plane you cannot miss. You have to visit this plane, and you have to experience what this plane has to offer below 4,000 meters as an energy fighter, because it is an experience you don't want to miss. And so highly recommended this plane. We have arrived at the attacker slash strike aircraft line with the PE-3 Bis sitting right here, coming from the IL-2s and the PE-3s from the earlier ranks. 3.3 battle rating. It is a plane that has a few strong points and has a few downsides. It has some nice armor on it that's good for the protection. And we do have forward-facing guns, which is interesting also to Barisins there, so good armament. The fuel is quite pronounced, a lot of fuel tanks in the wings and stuff like that, so a lot of risk for some fires. But yeah, that's life, I guess. Modifications. We do have some small limited options for bombs and stuff like that, 250 and 100 kilogram bombs as the biggest load. We do have rockets, no combinations, unfortunately, but it's not a big plane, so you can't put much on her, I guess. Let's check her out. So we're looking at the PE-3 Bis, the first aircraft in the attacker slash strike aircraft line. And it is an all right plane. I'm not particularly in love with this plane or anything. It's not particularly sturdy or survivable, which is something that you would love to have in an attacker at this battle rating. But it does have quite all right roll rate and reasonable maneuverability when it comes to that for such a big plane. Of course, it still cannot compete to most of the fighters, but there is that. What are the strong points in the PE-3? 3.3 battle rating, as I said. It has offensive guns that are fantastic at this battle rating for this line of aircraft. It has a 20mm gun with 250 rounds and two Barisin machine guns with over 200 rounds as well, which is quite nice for firepower. It is a versatile plane that can drop bombs, shoot rockets, it can shoot, it has offensive guns, So it is quite versatile, which is a good advantage in this plane for the roles that it has. And it has a dive speed that is stunning compared to some of the fighters that the plane that rank 3 Soviets has. And yeah, quite speedy on the in the dive, over 700, and the rip speed lies around 800, I believe, if I remember correctly. Weaknesses in this plane. Performance, especially the vertical performance, is not great. It doesn't have great climb rate either. That is due to the engine setup. It is just not very powerful when it comes to the engine performance. And in the vertical, it's really bad. Loses a lot of speed there, so stay out of that. Keep it in the horizontal. And yeah, climbing also not very great. So once you lose your altitude, you're gonna lose. You're not gonna gain it back very quickly. So that's important to keep in mind. The flight styles in this plane, it is a close air support aircraft. You can have 6 rockets with you or several bomb loads you can choose from, which are all right, nothing special. It doesn't excel in bomb loads or anything, but it's all right. It can also be a support fighter that comes in from the fringes with the firepower the plane has. It can definitely fulfill a role there. Is this plane competitive at this battle rating 3.3? I would still say yes, but I would say barely, because it is struggling at the 3.3, the PE3. So yeah, it is a struggle bus, but it can still compete a little bit because of its versatile nature, and especially in down tiers and on its own battle rating. In up tiers, it's going to be even more of a struggle bus. Because of this fact, I would say the fun factor in this plane is low. You need a lot of work in this plane, and you also need to be a little bit lucky. It is a big target for the enemy planes, and the planes at this battle rating, they do get their firepower on point. So yeah, it is not the greatest amount of fun I've ever had in a plane. Can you recommend this plane? How high do you value her? I cannot really recommend this plane now. I don't like the plane particularly. I really prefer the IL-2s. They have much more upsides to talk about it. It's better rating. I would not recommend it. I would skip it and move on to the IL-2s if I were you. The next plane we're looking at is the IL-2-37. Very interesting plane, sitting in a little folder here with the IL-2 M1943. Right here, 2.7 battle rating. It's a very interesting and unique plane. It is very heavy because of those huge guns. It's a little bit of a downside. Of course, this is a tank, as often said, a big flying armored beast with a good package in protection for the gunner and the pilot. More the pilot than the gunner. He's not protected from some size, but oh well. And the guns are very nice, of course, 37 millimeters, a lot of ammo, and the smaller caliber as well. So there we have it. We have fuel tanks right here, and right there. That is nicely situated. Not a lot of wing fires you're gonna get on this one. There is not a lot of ordnance on this one because this is the 37 millimeter version. It relies on these two puppies, and they work. They do work, but they have downsides as well, and I will explain them. So we arrive at some of the most famous planes for the Soviets, the IL-2 Sturmoviks. This is the IL-2-37, equipped with 37 millimeter guns, a set of them with an insane amount of ammo. The rest of the ordnance in this plane is really limited because this plane relies on the 37 millimeters. It has a lot of them, and they can perform very nicely, but they also make sure that this plane has some extreme downsides that are not great. The plane sits at 2.7 battle rating, and it should be that low because it is really not a great performer. The main I'll get to that later. Let's first go into the strengths of this plane. The offensive guns are a definite strength. You have the machine guns, and you have the two 37 mm cannons, which are awesome, and they have an insane amount of ammo, which is very nice to have, but it also makes the plane very heavy and much less maneuverable. The durability, of course, in the Sturmoviks is great. They are flying tanks renowned for their durability in the war, survivability. It is a flying tank basically with armor all around. You sit in a armored box as a pilot, and you're very safe when it comes to that. Okay, there are definite weaknesses to this plane as well though. First of all is that the web is broken at ground level. It doesn't give you extra power there, so but that is a bug, needs to be fixed. Moving on to the speed, it's a very slow plane and it cannot dive as very well either. It doesn't have great speed when it comes to that. Climb rate is very bad. The plane is so heavy, especially this one with the 37mm and the insane amount of ammo. Very heavy plane, climb rate is crap. Turn time is also bad because of all this weight, which was always one of the strengths of the IL-2s. It is gone. No turn time in this plane. Performance is not great either, and the bomb loads in this plane are crap. You are relying on the 37mm in this plane. So that's a lot of downsides. The flight style in this plane is close air support or support fighter. The 37mm with AP rounds can be devastating to tanks and stuff like that. There is no doubt about that. You have a lot of ammo, so if people leave you alone, you can destroy an insane amount of tanks. And the plane can also function as a support fighter, but you should not rely on the turn time and the maneuverability that you used to have in the IL-2s in the horizontal. It used to be fantastic, and now it is very bad. So support fighting role is a little bit more difficult because of that. Is this plane competitive? No. This plane has much less options than the earlier IL-2s, and at this battle rating it is difficult to make this plane function. It is it has upsides, but it is so unmaneuverable, it's become a brick basically. Fun factor because of that is also low. If a plane gets comes above you and you have no defense, you're basically dead when a plane attacks you, unless it's head-on. But you're still surprised with how many times people do head-on with you, but low fun factor for me. How highly do you recommend this plane? Do you value her? No, not really. I have a low recommendation for you on this plane. It is just not that great. Moving on to the IL-2Ms, we have the 1943, which is in the folder here with the 37 right here. 3.3 battle rating, and the Type 3, which is also 3.3 battle rating. These planes are heavier and less maneuverable than the original IL-2s because of this gunner. And it really doesn't help the maneuverability, the turn time. We still have the armor protection as always. And we have the guns, 23mm cannons and the machine guns, which is all good, that firepower. Fuel tanks, same setup. They all have the same setup when it comes to that. Of course, the options which you have for bombs, rockets or combos of those two are very nice, and you have some very nice bomb loads on there. But yeah, they are less maneuverable. I find that to be a distinct downside, but oh well. Let's check these planes out. So here we are with the IL-2Ms. There is two of them, the 1943 and the Type 3. They are the real successors of the earlier IL-2s, but they are different because they have gunners and makes them quite a bit heavier. The 37 was even more heavy because of the insane amount of ammo on those 37mm guns, which it has two of. These ones are a little bit more maneuverable in the turn time, but still not great, and that's because these M's have gunners, and I really don't like these gunners. Takes away the magnificent turn time that the IL-2s used to have, and it makes it a lot less fun. But anyway, let's go into it. The strength in these planes, offensive guns, they have 23mm guns, two of them with machine guns. Very nice to have offensive guns, devastating. Durability in these planes are fantastic. Flying tanks, as I said, nothing different in this plane. Great armor protection. These are awesome planes when it comes to survivability. Very durable. Bomb loads are also great. Many rockets and bombs and combinations between those two. A lot of options in this plane. Very nice, really. Good strengths. Great for an attacker. There are also weaknesses in this plane, of course. It has the speed, which is a definitive downside. Not great in a dive. It has climb rate that is bad, of course. This plane is so heavy that it really doesn't want to climb, which is logical with all that armor protection and stuff like that. The turn time is not great because of that gunner and the extra armor protection on it because of that. Doesn't make it great, but it seems to be worse on the Type 3. I could not really discover why. It looks to be the same plane, same armor, looks to have the same guns. I could not really discover it, but it has a much less time. It has a much worse turn time than the 43, so I don't know what that is. Performance is also not great. It is very difficult, of course, for an engine to perform with all this armor and a gunner and the bombs and stuff like that. So keep that in mind. The flight style in these two IL-2Ms is close air support and support fighter. It can still perform the close air support role very well. Support fighting is going to be a little bit more difficult because it really doesn't have the same turn time as what you used to on the earlier IL-2s from rank 2, which is unfortunate. Is this plane still competitive? I would say yes. Both of them are still competitive at 3.3 battle rating. But the fun factor is a lot lower. It is medium on these planes. You have a lot of survivability, you have great ordnance, you have great guns, and you would be surprised at the amount of people that still want to head on this plane, which makes they're still fun to have in this plane, but the great fun of out-turning fighters and stuff like that and holding your own in turn fights, that one is gone. So medium fun factor. Do you recommend this plane? How high do you value her? I would say medium. This is a plane that can fulfill a role. It is great at the ground pounding role, but it is not as fun or great as the earlier IL-2. So still better than the PE-3. So there is that medium recommendation for this plane from me. So we arrived at the bomber line and we're starting off with the Yur 2 M105 4.0 beta rating. It sits in a little folder with its twin sister, the Yur 2. With some other stuff at the back. But two year twos we have here, both 4.0 battle rating. We have limited armor protection, but still nice displayed here for this gunner. And the place for the pilots, nothing in front, unfortunately. We have the X-ray. This fuel tank setup is so extensive that anywhere you will be hit, you can have problems. In the wing section fuselage. So we have that. It's unfortunate. We do have two pilots there, which is nice. Only three gunners. This first one has only small caliber guns, which is really disappointing. But we do have some big bomb setups, which is quite nice. Actually quite nice right there. So bomb loads are good, but let's have a look at the rest of her. So here we are with the Yur 2s in the bomber line. The first two bombers in the rank 3 bomber line. Ach, man, I don't like the Yur 2s. I can't help it. The gunners and the gunner spread are not great. Especially on the first one, which has three 7.62mm machine guns. I mean, small caliber pop guns. It is very frustrating to fly Yur 2s. I can say that. 4.0 battle rating. What are the strengths in these bombers? There is, of course, the bomb loads. The bomb loads in these planes are fan-freaking-tastic. You have four 500 kilogram bombs and 2,000 kilogram bombs for the main big load. You have other loads that you get earlier on, but that is a definite upside. The bomb loads are great. Durability in this plane is also good. You can take a shit ton of damage, but believe me, you will take that damage because it is difficult to shoot enemy planes out of the sky with this with these pop guns. It's just not great when it comes to defensive gunners, but the durability is good. You also have two pilots, which may also be an upside there. Weaknesses is the speed. This is a very slow bomber, very slow plane in a straight line. And 4.0 battle rating, you will meet some fighters that are way, way quicker than you. And this plane definitely is not fast. The gunners are definite downsides to this plane as well. Three gunner placements. In the first one, they both sit at 4.0. There's no difference. First one has three pop guns. The second one actually has two Barrisons. So that is already a lot better. But the placement of the gunners is not great. Doesn't give a great spread. There's some definite weak sides, especially in front, where the plane is very vulnerable. So the gunner placements are not great. The climb rate in this plane is absolutely devastating. It's very bad. It is not something to write home about. Maneuverability in the plane is bad. And the fuel tanks are so spread out, you are a flying fire pinata. And it seems to be that you catch a fire almost every time you get shot at. That's what my experience was like. I hope it's different for you, but I don't think so. Don't think it was coincidence. The flight style in this plane is very clear. It is a base bomber, mainly. It can, of course, close air support, but the plane is not very maneuverable. It's very sluggish in the roll rate and in small maneuvers. So it's not ideally suited for close air support. It is a base bomber, basically, especially with those big bomb loads, which are also catered to that. Is this plane competitive? I would say no. I don't like the Year 2s. They don't... Well, here we go with the fires. Not very competitive, this plane. The gunners... the only thing that's nice about this plane that's really nice is the bomb loads. And I mean, durability is one thing if it functions to get your gunners to do something, but that is difficult. Though the one with the Barisins is a little bit better. Fun factor in this plane is low. You'll have a lot of frustration in this plane, a lot of fires. These planes are often attacked very quickly because people know that they are weak in the gunner placements and stuff like that. So yeah, low fun factor, very frustrating. Recommended, do you value this plane? No, low recommendation from me. I would not fly this plane, I would skip it. I would fly something else if you are hell-bent on flying a bomber in rank 3 Soviets. I would look at something like PE-8 before I would go for a Year 2. I would unlock the later bombers with fighters or attackers and skip these Year 2s. Just unlock them and never look at them again. Ah, the big mama of rank 3 Soviets, the PE-8, sitting at 4.3 battle rating. What a badass, big-ass machine. Lovely. It sits right here. Here's the Year 2s. We sit here, the PE-8. We do have a little bit of armor. Here's some protection for the gunners here. Pilot protection. But for the rest, there's precious little armor on there. We do have big fuel tanks spaced out over the wing, so there is that. You gotta put that fuel somewhere. There's nothing in the fuselage, there's that. But the wings are a little bit vulnerable for fires. You'll keep that. That's what it is. We have a very interesting bomb here, the 5000 kilogram bomb, which actually has explosive mass of 3361 with a TNT equivalent of 5041.5 kilograms, which is an amazing blast. Love to drop that on the airfield. You do have some close air support bomb loads as well. 4100 kilogram, 6500s, 12 250s, and 4 1000s that you can use in whatever way you want to use it. So nice bomber, and let's see if she disappoints or not. The PE-8, this is a big ass bomber, lovely to see as always. This is one of the more fun bombers for the Soviets, although it's still a big target that can take quite the attention. People know to look out a little bit more for this one, so it doesn't get swarmed so much as the Year 2s. This plane sits at 4.3 battle rating. Now, what are the strengths in this plane? The bomb loads are fantastic. You have a 5,000 kilogram bomb, which is awesome. It is fun to play around with. It's really a meme plane when it comes to that, with that bomb. But it also has great other bomb loads. 40 times 100 kilogram bombs, for example, or 12 times 250 if you want to go for a close air support run on columns or stuff like that. It has very versatile bomb loads. Also 4 times 1,000 kilogram bombs. Nice bomb loads. Gunners are also great. You have 2 20mm guns, 2 Barisins, and 2 7.62 machine guns, which is great. The gunner placements and the guns, they are fantastic. The guns are beautiful. The durability on the plane is also good. It is a very sturdy plane that can take quite a bit of damage. Are there any weaknesses to this plane? Yes, of course. It is very slow. The speed is one of the main downsides. It's a very, very slow plane in a straight line. There is no climb rate on this bomber. some of the B-17s and B-25s and some of the other big bombers, although B-25 is a bit more small, but ME-264, stuff like that, they have better engines, more quality to the climb rate. This plane doesn't have this plane doesn't have that. Doesn't have any climb rate. Maneuverability is also very bad, not great, which is a definite downside. Although the roll rate is not terrible for such a big plane. But turn time is just not great. The flight style in this plane, well, it's a base bomber first, and it can do that very nicely, especially with that 5,000 kilogram bomb. You can save that for the airfield. It has awesome TNT value. Can do a shit ton of damage, but then you need other people to do the bases first, and you don't always have that. It can do some close air support. The roll rate is reasonable, but it's still not recommended. I would keep it low, or high, sorry. You can use your guns to maximum potential then, but you can use it. It does have the bomb loads to do that. 40 times 100 kilogram bombs and 12 times 250. It's not bad at all. Is this plane competitive? Yes, it is the bomber to go to. If you want to fly a bomber for the Soviets rank 3, it is definitely competitive with those gunners and the survivability the plane has. The fun factor in the plane is medium. You will have to get good at aiming these guns, and you still get a lot of planes that come for you with great firepower at this beta rating, so it can be difficult. Do you recommend this plane? How high do you value her? I would say a medium recommendation. If you are a bomber pilot, you definitely should use the PE-8. It's the best of the bunch. But if you are an attacker pilot or a fighter pilot that wants to look at a bomber, I would definitely not look at the bombers at this battle rating. It's just not great all around. The PE-8 is alright, but not fantastic. So here we have it. Last and maybe least, the PE-2s. There is two of them. One at 4.0 battle rating here in the little folder, and one 4.3 with a little bit better engine performance and stuff like that. These planes, I don't know what they're doing here. I didn't like the PE2s here, and they're not great here in rank 3 at 4.0, 4.3. They're going to get a lot of opposition. There is armor protection for the pilots, for the gunners, which is nice to have. The fuel setup is quite extensive, and you do have forward-facing offensive guns, which is of course nice to have in a bomber. We do have some limited bomb loads on this one, nothing too fancy. It is not a big plane, so you can't expect too much, but those four 250s are a loadout that I quite like. For the rest, offensive-facing guns and some options to play the game in different roles. Let's have a look what she can do. The last of the bunch, the PE-2s, there is two of them, one at 4.0 and one at 4.3 beta rating. These flight models are really getting outdated at this beta rating, the PE-2s. I don't really like them here, but there are some upsides to these bombers, which are light bombers, of course. The offensive guns, you have offensive guns, which is always nice, a Barasin and a 7.62mm, which is nice. You have limited bomb loads, but they are alright for such a small plane. You're very durable, it's a survivable plane. You have good roll rate and dive speed with a 740-ish rip speed, which is quite nice for a plane like this. So there are definitely some upsides to this plane, but there are also weaknesses to the plane. The turn time really is not that great. You have performance issues right now. I mean, the flight model is old. It's been used in earlier planes, and it wasn't spectacular back then anyway. And it becomes less good at 4.0, 4.3. The opposition is so good. It's going to be difficult. There is also overheating in this plane, especially with a lot of web usage, which is a definite downside to this plane. What is the flight style to this PE-2s? Close air support and support fighter, although the guns are not too great at this battle rating, of course, and the maneuverability is a little bit lacking. So it's difficult, more difficult to perform that role. Close air support role as well. You have the forward facing gun, you can also use them for soft targets, use the bomb for the heavier targets. or the rockets. The plane does have options when it comes to that. So both roles are viable. Is this plane competitive though at this beta rating? I would say no. I didn't like them in the earlier beta ratings, and I don't like them now at all either. The fun factor in these planes is low. You do get a lot of planes that go for you because people know the planes are weak. It is difficult to fly and is not a lot of fun. Do you recommend the plane? How high do you value her? I do not recommend this plane. It's a low recommendation. I do not like them. I think the performance is not great. I think the planes, the frame is not good anymore at this beta rating, and I think they have no place at 4.0, 4.3. Yeah, I mean, they still have a role and you can still make them work, as any good pilot tries to make what you have work at a better rating. The better the pilot, the better the results in the end. But this flight model and the plane, the way it's set up, it doesn't help you at this better rating to perform. So there is that. I would definitely not recommend this. I would skip it. I would stick with the PE-8 if you want to bomb in this plane. Hey guys, you made it to the end section of the video, the guide and tips section, where I will look at the rank with you and will give you my tips on which plane you might talisman to give you a more smooth performance, which planes you definitely want to visit and which planes you want to skip. Now, there are several roads to take, of course. This also depends whether you're an attacker bomber pilot or you are a fighter pilot. As a fighter pilot, there is four planes that are the center and on the front and center of what you don't want to miss. The I-185, the LA-5FN, the Yak-9T and the Yak-3. Those four planes are very good, and I like all of them. Let's not kid ourselves. The Yak-3P, the Yak-K, the 9K, the LA-5F are also good planes, but those planes are things you might not want to miss as a fighter pilot. So in that sense, there might be several routes you want to take. I would always go in here in the I-185 myself. I prefer that, but the LA-5F is also an option. I-185 to LA-5FN could be a good combination. Two planes that I really like, but I prefer the LA-5FN over the I-185. That could be a route. And then moving on to the Yak-3, for example, you can also go from the I-185 to the Yak-9T and then on to the Yak-3. I think the Yak-3 should always be your bread and butter in this rank. It is the best plane here by far because of the battle rating differences. The Yak-3 has better performance than the Yak-3P, and it is a full battle rating lower with barisins instead of 20mm. So you can debate what you think is better, but I don't think the barisins underperform compared to the 20mm that the Yak-3P has, and I don't like that extra battle rating on top. So I would always go for the Yak-3 as my main fighter to go through all of these. I would want to unlock everything, of course, that's how you always do it, but if you only go for fighters, that's the route you want to take, and then moving on to rank 4. If you're more of an attacker / bomber pilot, there's only two options that are viable, in my opinion. The IL-2 1943 and the PE-8. Those two are the ones you want to use. The rest is just pain. And I mean, we want to avoid pain in this grind, right? The grind in War Thunder is already big and painful enough to experience too much pain in rank 3 Soviet. The PE-3 Biz, it's all right. It has some upsides. It has some downsides. Skip it. The IL-2 34. Too heavy, the big guns, no ordnance. It doesn't turn at all, it's a brick. Go to the IL-2M as soon as you can. Maybe use the PE-3 to unlock that as soon as you can. Or if you can also use fighters a little bit, use the I-185 or something like that to get to that plane and then start using this plane. It's the best turner of these three IL-2s. Type 3, for some reason, is a much heavier turner than the 1943, so use that. And if you want to, you could move up to the PE-8 if you like some bombing as well. These Yer-2s, they're not worthy of your time. They are very painful, especially the first one with those pop guns. The other one does have two Barazins, but this one has the Barazins, but it's still not fantastic. They do have decent bomb loads, but the PE-8 has that 5,000 kilo bomb, which is a lot of fun to work with. The PE-2s, I don't even want to discuss. Skip these things, just unlock them and move on. But yeah, the 1943 here at 3.3 battle rating and a PE-8 are your bread and butter for the attacker and bomber line. And that's how you want to dose that you want to use to unlock this line if you're a bomber or attacker pilot. So yeah, that's it, guys. Potential talismans is the IA-185 could be. This one I would actually recommend as the main one together with the Yak 3. Those two planes are talisman worthy. And especially this one and the LF-5FN is also fantastic. So whatever has your preference once you use them, I would talisman those and make it a little bit easier if you want to spend some money. For the bombers and attackers, I'm not an attacker or a bomber. It would be those same two planes that I talked about, the 1943 or the PE-8. But I personally, I'm not one of those pilots that want to spend a lot of money on the bombers. So I wouldn't put talismans on there. But if you are a fanatic ground attacker, I could imagine you would want to put a talisman on this one. It's a very good plane. Maybe the PE-8, but I would prefer the IL. It's just a little better when it comes to, for me, because I'm a fighter pilot. Maybe if you're actually a bomber pilot, base bomber, you want to use this one. Can be a lot of fun as well. Anyway, guys, I hope that helped you out. I hope it makes rank 3 a little bit smoother for you. We'll move along to rank 4 soon, and you can look forward to that video in a couple of weeks, maybe a month's time. Guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I want to thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye. If you're new here, make sure to hit the subscribe button, become part of this community. If you are already a subscriber, don't forget to like the video, do leave me a comment, and if you really feel like helping out today, make sure to share the video with your friends and let them know about the channel.